Well, you know what? When I was younger, I've had a lot of relationships where men used to tell me, you know, I wasn't all that and I was ugly and how if I, without them, I would never be nothing. Well, now that I'm older, I'm taking all of that and I'm flipping it. I'm like, look, I am somebody and I don't need you to do this. I'm doing it myself. And now it's time to build up my self-esteem. You know what I mean? I'm like bringing it back. Like, I'm doing this because I feel good about myself and what I'm doing.
Which was something that I read about and I had no idea about your life, was when you talked about being in an abusive relationship.
Yeah, it was hard. And I shared that story because people think, you know, once celebrities, especially females, get into the industry, they feel like we're so different. But I just wanted females to know that I went through the same thing while I was some people's role models and Lil Kim. And I mean, I had broken nose, black eyes, all that stuff.
I've had broken noses, I've had, you know, blood clots in my back, and I was losing myself.
Have you ever been back after being hit?
No, after the very intense one, no. But, I mean, in the beginning, yeah, I did go back. I learned that, you know, if it's continuously abusive, you just can't stay there.
He never really put me down in the way where he thought, you know, he made my self-esteem bad as far as saying, oh, I was unattractive. He thought I was beautiful, but he just... You know, he had a problem, and I think sometimes women get stuck on thinking we could change a man or thinking, you know, he's sick and we can help him, and that wasn't the case. We the same people, I believe, just like y'all. Same people, I got feelings just like y'all, and that's the whole thing. Like, we still, at the end of the day, human. You just got to be strong and say, that I am beautiful. As women, we gotta know that. You know, you really gotta sit and look in the mirror sometime and say that to yourself, whether you feel it or not. You gotta just say it and believe that.
And you talked about how, I guess, you had to fix your nose too after one point, mm-hmm. Right?
I had fixed it already, and then right. After that, it was broke again. So I had to fix
you had
it
to
again.
Go again. So that was an unplanned surgery.
Yeah, it was. That's why my go to the side.
Does it bother you when people? I don't know, talk about it, or when people have jokes about it or comments about it, because I see it all, you know, you see it all the time or hear it, and I'm sure you hear it.
No, it don't bother me. It don't bother me because, you know, I told you, I'm beautiful. She likes me. I love myself. You know, I mean, you know, there's certain things that I think I was obsessive with, you know what I mean, in which, you know, I always have time to fix or whatever. But, you know, but the thing of it is that people think, I did it because I had low self-esteem, but that wasn't the case. I think I did it because I was a little too vain, you know, at the time. So
trying to be perfect?
Trying to be perfect. I'm a perfectionist. That's true.
At the end of the day, it's like, you know, believe in something and always try to stay positive. We're not perfect, so negative is going to peek in, and the devil's going to play and dance with you sometimes, but as long as you keep God first.
Lil Kim has been making headlines because of her dramatic new look.
She posted where she looks completely different, almost unrecognizable, with the biggest difference being her skin tone. It's not even brown anymore.
Lil Kim, the rap star, appears to be lightening her skin, but why?
Remarkably white, and her new Caucasian look caused...
Well, if you ever vote TV, you can see what those pictures look like.
How do we know that's just not makeup and lighting, though?
I think that's a filter. I seen Kim a couple of weeks ago in the club.
Yeah, it could be a filter.
And it looked like that's not, she's not
it could be. It could be a filter, it could be makeup, it could be lighting. Like, why do y'all jump out the window so quickly?
Oh, my God. You're a fucking thing. You're fucking white. You have no melanin, bitch. Danger retention.
I think internet bullying is something that really needs to stop, you know.
At the end of the day, you know, us celebrities have it worse because we're constantly ridiculed, constantly. You know, what's the difference between some young boy telling another young boy to go kill themselves because you're gay or whatever, and then all these people who have these blogs that criticize the freaking celebrities and tell them, you need to sit down, you need to go kill yourself, you need to do this. What's the difference? The difference is most of us celebrities have to put on a, you know what I'm saying, straight face. We have to deal with all of that and still walk out, and we still have to sleep, you know, and we still have to greet our fans, and we probably have to be a little stronger. We probably have a more support system because there's more people pushing us. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a little kid out there who's 14, 15, has no support system. Mom, dad's probably not there or not home, and they don't have anyone.
Please tell me a little bit about your foundation. Oh, well, Lil Kim cares. Right now, we're doing an auction, which is going to go to children.
Benefit a lot of Kim's charities.
Yes, yes. Let's just shed light on these girls and say congratulations.
Beautiful
black.
You know, I'm a strong person. I'm very strong. I got my own mind. Any situation, I've always been able to handle.
I'm a lot stronger with my faith, you know, mainly because of the things that I've gone through. And, you know, those things caused me to have a closer relationship with God. He's never left me, even during the bad times, you know. That's my best friend.
The first thing I gotta do is thank you, Father God. Let me tell you, I thank you so much, Father God, because you just keep lifting me up higher and higher, even through the harshest times. And he lets me know he's always there, even when I think he's gone. And that's the one thing that keeps me going. I want to thank the Killer Beehive. You are always there for me. Let me tell you, if I could take you guys with me everywhere I go, I would do that, because you guys help me to get through everything as well, and y'all make me want to keep going every single time.
I come from the streets, the world of racism and poverty is hard to make peace. Little girl with big dreams, you don't have to settle. We gon' get out the ghetto. We fight, but still things ain't right. Too many dying. Lord knows I keep trying.
And I just want to say that, you know, brutality has gotten to an all-time high. It is horrible. And we as a people can stick together and do something about that. And speak our voice and our opinion and really just support the community. And you know what? Love is bigger than anything.